Everybody out of my pocket. But it is no love, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost. Think about that when we look at what the kingdom of God is. Another point to consider. And these are just prereqs to what I really want to deal with on getting through midnight. Is that right? Luke 17:20-21 says, once on being asked by the Pharisees when the kingdom of God will come, Jesus replied, the coming of the kingdom of God is not something that can be observed. Nor will people say, here it is, or there it is, because the kingdom of God is in your midst. Jesus is talking to the Pharisees, they're saying, okay, where is the kingdom at? If you're talking to me, you see in the kingdom. It's like I couldn't say it's inside of them because they hadn't confessed him as Lord and Savior and they hadn't become disciples. So he said to them, it's in your midst. He's saying to us, because we're in him, the kingdom of God is in you by the Holy Spirit. Remember, love, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost. The kingdom of God is not an outward expression, but it's love, joy, and peace in the Holy Ghost. Amen. And so he's telling the Pharisees, and the second thing to consider, amen, it's a mist, it's around you. It's me, it's what is in me. It's the mission I've been sent to complete. It's, amen, it's the voice of the Father. It's the new way, amen. It's really the new world order. That's what the kingdom of God is. It's the new world order. See, the fallen world has their idea of how to construct a new kingdom, and they're calling it the new world order, but he has already come with the mandate of the new world order. His name is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of you are new world order citizens? I am. I'm in God's new world order. It's called the kingdom of God, and I'm a kingdom son, and I have kingdom inheritance, and I got kingdom promises that I can execute every day in the name of the one that the kingdom of birds, which is Jesus Christ, are Yeshua HaMashiach. Now, whenever you, those of you that still got great grandparents living, my grandparents. wearing their Matriot t-shirts or little sweater they be wearing. They don't have to be riding with it. But just because they know they're a part of their cheerleading squad for their championship football team, they even be doing it in an intermission before class. You see them? Okay, maybe that's just where I was from in the Midwest. I don't know if they do it out here. We call it team spirit. Where is your team spirit, body of Christ? Oh, that might, if I do that, that might embarrass me. If I do that, they might label me as one of the ones in all of the Nazarene. If I do that, no, I can't do that. But Jesus got a response.
Read.
praying about him all week. Then I want him to, amen, give kidneys on Sunday morning. He's already done everything he needs to do. When he comes back, it's finality. When he comes back, he's coming with gifts and rewards in his hand. Guess what? He's on his way back. He's closer today than he was yesterday. That's all I can tell you about his coming. He's closer today than he was yesterday. And tomorrow, he's going to be closer than he was today. Don't never lose sight of that as if you're a kingdom son and daughter. Approach or reevaluate your list of priorities. Because I guarantee you what's really important to you ain't important to God if he ain't in the center of them all. If you ain't allowed him to put it together, then it's of no use to him. But God, all these ideas I have, they gonna make the kingdom look real good. Amen. I didn't tell you to do that. You sacrificed to do that, and it's not a bad thing, but I didn't tell you to do that. It's not obedience. I mean, obedience is better than sacrifice. So what God was really saying was obedience over sacrifice. Okay. You went and bought a church, took the money and bought a church. You gave to somebody. But that wasn't my will for you and that money. It benefited somebody. But I didn't tell you to do that. But it was a good work, God. I didn't tell you to sacrifice that. I told you to obey me, Adam. I told you to obey me, Eve. Serpent, you're going to obey me. Woman, you're going to toil having babies. You're going to desire the authority of your husband. Husband, you're going to sweat by the brow of by the skin of your brow all the days of your life instead of just speaking. Because before that, Adam didn't have to worry about sweating because all he had to do was speak. Before the disobedience came in, all Adam had to do was speak and deal abundance. He spoke. He named everything around him. Amen. He measured everything was in order. But it wasn't by the strength of his muscle. The only muscle he used was the faith of his word and the relationship he had with God. But when disobedience came in, God said, you're going to see some hard days, brother. This is why Jesus, amen, sweated blood from his brow, because it represented the first judgment of man on God. He was the second Adam fulfilling all of that. Now it's your tilling ground. I'm coming to sweat that same air so I can bring deliverance and you can rest in me. Draw blood. Why? So that this mind that's in Christ Jesus could be in you now. Everything that was done wrong or we forfeited by the first Adam, Christ had to do as the second Adam. He had to restore everything that was taken from us in the garden back to us. He was the bridge. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can't mess with me. Amen. Because I come in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and I say to myself sometimes when the enemy hit me real hard, you might want to watch yourself because I'm a chosen for you. You need to get under that mantle of teaching. You need to open yourself up, and you need to get processed and discipled. Did the disciples hang out with Jesus and John? Did they run from Jesus to John to Gamaliel? Oh, I heard John doing something down by the riverside. Hey, Jesus, hold up. Go down there by the riverside. John baptized 15 people. Hey, Jesus, when you going to baptize some folks? John baptized 15 people. Oh, Gamaliel. Hey, oh, he was teaching some deep stuff today. Why ain't we hearing that deep teaching in our church? All these conferences popping up. We running to, we running fro. We giving all our money to these conferences, and they provide funding and support for the local church. Don't give the credit, anointing, and mantle on the man or the woman of God who God has put over your soul to present you to the Lord. I'm talking about, this is where we at. Midnight. How are you going to conquer it if you don't know what it looked like? If you don't know what it looked like, you're going to be a repeat offender. And if every one of my messages make you feel happy, happy, joy, joy, and I never give you a sore toe, y'all need to check me out. Although sugar is in my recipe for making cake, the whole recipe ain't sugar. We doing all right?
Yes, sir.
We excited? Yes, hallelujah. So we should come with a praise already in us. We should come because God has chosen. We should come because God has promised. We should come because He's written your name in the Lamb of the Lord. If you've got your name written in the Lamb of the Lord, y'all know y'all name. It's written, that's a real thing. There's a book that the Lamb has, and when you came in a relationship, He wrote your name in it. I ain't got to see Him to know that He wrote my name in it. I'm walking in relationship with Him. My name is in the book. It's your name in the book. See, if you can believe that little simple, small thing, then you can believe other things that God has said. But if you can't even get past that, He sure ain't going to believe that there's demons. You're going to believe that you're going to be preaching like Reverend Knight and say, there is no Satan. It's just the bad thoughts that's in you that we call Satan. There is no God. It's just the God inside of us. And there's a good in this. This is kind of crazy stuff Reverend Knight was preaching. The central point of his message was money. It was mammon. He said, forget black power. Green power is what rules. And Reverend Knight was making $6 million. inside is they are men of God, and they're here to bring salvation. And so Paul had to deal with that. Because if he didn't deal with that, they would have thought that the demonic and the kingdom of God was family. Now, she was said to have been, they believed in the Greek mythology that Apollyon was the spirit, Apollos, the god Apollos, embodied the snake, the python snake, and it spoke the future. And so she was operating in the spirit of Python. Paul had to deal with that and let him know that even the cult can't stand to the name of Jesus Christ. Woman, get up out of there now! And then he touched the condom. Woman was kept, that demon was cast out, that woman, the spirit of Python was gone. That immediately messed with her master's finances. They ran to the magistrates, told it on them, said, they Jews, they coming up against Caesar and his bylaws, let's do something about it. Not once they even checked the resume and see if Paul was a Roman. See, how many know when God sends you on assignment, he's already equipped you with everything that you're going to need, but there's always a soul tied to that assignment. It's never about you. Yeah, you might get locked up. Yeah, you might get whipped with poles. Yeah, you might, but can you sing? Can you praise at midnight?
Church in the land that ain't preaching the Spirit of the Lord is born.
Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own. For ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Glorify God in your body. Glorify God in your body. Glorify God in your body. Glorify God in your spirit, which are God's. It belongs to Him. You belong to Him. So when I say y'all, what y'all want to do, don't mean that to God. It don't. Glorify God in your body and in your spirit. Know ye not that your body is the body of Christ, and ye are the temple of the Holy Spirit, that be that place which the Holy Spirit dwelleth? Glorify God in your body and in your spirit. This will help you with your life of lasciviousness. This will help you with your life of sin when you recognize as a kingdom son and daughter, amen, and my body's not mine no more. I'm a new creature, Lord. I walk a new way. I talk a new way. I hang out with new people. I don't do those things that I used to do.